Greetings, this is Darth Vader, Lord of the Sith and Commander of the Galactic Empire. It was during my meditation that I sensed a great disturbance in the Force. It was then I realized your age has increased your control of your emotions. This will give you a clearer path to the dark side. Most impressive. Remember, with control of your fear and anger, the dark side will be a powerful ally. Join me as we conquer the galaxy and buy vast amounts of lottery tickets. Consider it. Until then.
The trip began in Alberta, Western Canada, where she grew up on the edge of the prairie in the small town of Consort.
I'm not sure that I'd ever heard of it before we decided to move there, and it was a long drive because we had come from the Edmonton area, and I felt like I was going to the end of the world.
She was a big bone gal from southern Alberta, you just couldn't call her small.
I have four children, a son, and three daughters. Kathy is the youngest one. We moved to Consort because we had purchased the drugstore in Consort. Kathy was an infant at the time.
This is where I do all my sorting for the day. For some reason, color feeds me, and all the green here, just I drink it in. I miss it when I'm away from it. This kind of balances me out after spending the day in the studio amongst all the wires and the everything. It's a way of forgetting who you are when you're here. My friends that I have here I've had for about 15 years, so they, you know, they've known me before I went on this trip.
She had some losses that made her grow up quickly. Her father left. She lost three classmates in one accident at school. And those things tended to make her grow up quickly, I think.
Right at 13, after Dad left, I just kind of went doing. I just stopped being a kid. And I never really kind of stopped and grieved because I think I switched into the protective thing for my mom. You're only as deep as what is carved into you. That feeling of loss is totally, totally represented in what I do. I've only started to realize how lonely I was there, but how it incubated this kind of internalization and this kind of frame for my imagination. And then for my 21st birthday, I was given two Patsy Cline records, and I started listening to songs like Stop the World and Three Cigarettes and the rockabilly stuff. And it blew my mind. So sort of just started happening. And then all of a sudden one day I just had this vision of what I wanted to do. I wanted to do country.
She would play her guitar and sing at school, at bridal showers or at church or things like that. This is from a musical which she was in, Country Chorale. And she was playing the part of a character who was something of a Patsy Cline. Is that my little girl up there? She has talent. That was when I just knew it then.
I don't want to disillusion you. I just want you to draw a conclusion to love. I wrote it for my teacher who I was madly in love with. She liked it. She was very cool. She was married, but she was cool with it. I mean, you know, you take your chances when you're a young homo. to rodeos as a teenager because one of my girlfriends was in love with a cowboy. So I used to go with her. I wanted to be a cowboy. They are handsome. I feel like I really have a lot of male energy, and I am very maternal and very female in terms of my, there's a very feminine side to me, but I think I'm getting more feminine emotionally all the time. You have to live your life exactly how you're ready to face the consequences. Being honest, being vulnerable, being just exactly what you are helps a lot, but it's just it's a small thing in the process of being grounded and comfortable with yourself.
K.D. Lang is a Grammy Award-winning singer, but radio stations in at least 6 states have banned her music. Why? What did she say that was so terrible? Well, take a look at this. It's a sneak preview of a soon-to-be-released public service announcement made by an organization called People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals.
Hi, I'm Katie Lang, and this is Lulu. We're with the People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals. We all love animals, but why do we call some pets and some dinner? If you knew how meat was made, you'd lose your lunch. I know, I'm from cattle country, and that's why I became a vegetarian. Meat stinks, and not just for the animals, but for human health and the environment.
A Montana radio station told us it would be suicide to play Katie Lang music after that.
Alberta is the largest beef-producing province in the country, and local ranchers are not impressed by KD's anti-meat message.
It's irresponsible. I could go further than that, I suppose, but we'll leave it at irresponsible.
The way I looked, the way I ate, who I slept with, the fact that I made fun of country music at the same time that I loved it, I mean, I just am everything they aren't. And my common denominator is that I love the music.
Became rather uncomfortable, let's put it that way. The sign at the entrance to the town had been there for a few years, and during this episode it was defaced. As a matter of fact, I asked the town council if they would take it down, which they did. And it hasn't been replaced, although they've wanted to replace it, but that's going to be Kathy's decision, not mine.
I didn't like the line, I knew I grew up in cattle country. I remember fighting Dan, the guy from PETA, about that line, and he said, well, that's going to be the one, and it was the one. And I didn't want to say that, you know, because at the same time, I respect those people. I respect the people that I grew up with. I know them, I love them. I wasn't strong enough at that point to know. You get put in really difficult positions.
Did it hurt you?
Yes, it hurt me. Absolutely. But it didn't kill me.
I just don't think that Nashville was ready for K.D. Lang. Her political stance about meat and other things and fur, her persona, everything. I think it was a problem.
Well, there's Boots Menard and Rocket Richard and the girls from way down Kakadee. How many bulldozers?
K.D. and her backup band are the most clean-cut bunch of musicians you've ever met. Their worst vice is M&M's. She calls them Katie's Canadian Camp, rolling through America, bringing a sound that's neither pure country, nor pop, nor jazz. Kathy Dawn Lang is the woman in charge here, even though she looks like one of the boys on the bus.
She was a big bone gal from southern Alberta. You just wouldn't call her small. You get every Saturday night, she'd be headed for the Legion.
She's a tall, big-boned gal and proud of it. But Katie Lang has always had to take some flack over the way she looks.
Yeah, but listen, I know what you're trying to say. But the thing is that assertiveness and self-confidence is viewed upon as a male characteristic, which is bull.
Right, so why do you have to dress like that if you are assertive anyway?
I don't see why you shouldn't dress any way you want to.
Mandrake root and venom of snake. A spoonful of fat and slimy old snails. Then a sprinkle of yellowed and rotten toenails. Next, I'll drop in the brew one pale zombie eye and a bucket of slop from a smelly pigsty. Perhaps the feathers of a raven and hair of a black cat would make a tasty addition to my boiling vat.
Cat, cat, cat!
Then a pinch of toad flax and the tail of a rat. And to give it some bite, these rare vampire bats. A dash of nightshade and a few lizard's gizzards. Then I'll top it all off with these fresh pumpkin innards. And finally, for good measure, with my brew nearly done, I just need the taste of a human sweet tongue. Come, my dearie, just a small sip.
I have had a constant craving to have a little chat with her for a long time now. Please welcome K.D. Lang.
Oh,
here we are.
Thank
lovely.
You.
Lovely. You call me Ed. Now, what do I call you? K.D.?
K.D. will be fine, yeah.
I'll call you K.D. Yeah. You're very chic. You're very appealing. I get a lovely vibe from you already. What does K.D. stand for?
Catherine Dawn.
There's a famous picture, K.D., of you, which was on the cover, I think, of Vanity Fair, with Cindy Crawford. Now, I want to have a look at that.
Yeah.
That is Cindy Crawford shaving, or pretending to shave you. Remember that?
Yes, I do remember that.
A bit spooky. Did you ever regret that? I like the pictures.
I never regretted that, no.
You're like me. I don't think you regret much at all, K.D.
No, I didn't regret that one.
I think there's too much fuss about this gender business. There are whole articles, women's magazines full of it. It's a sort of fad, really. I think women might be too liberated.
You do?
Well, do you get that feeling?
Yes.
I think so. It's all overdone.
Definitely.
I think we are liberated. Look at us.
Yes, I don't think we need to liberate
anybody. Here we are, three very liberated women chatting away like this. I'm going to be a bit liberated now.
Yeah.
I'm going to talk about something personal. This could offend people. I never want to run away from confrontations. My son, Kenny, who made this, designed this beautiful,
beautiful
dress.
Beautiful.
Well,
beautiful.
He made some decisions, K.D., and I embraced them as far as it was possible for me to do so.
Well, you're a liberal, loving woman is what you are.
I am, darling. I surrender to the love in my heart. And I don't think there's anything that two intelligent women cannot discuss. There's no taboo. I make no apologies for the words, for the terminology, perhaps the coarse terminology that I'm going to use now. When did you first know you were Canadian? Would you be offended if I said I prefer you to Donald Sutherland, Margaret Atwood, and Leonard Cohen rolled into one? Because they do often roll into one, I don't know. Would you say you were proudly Canadian?
Yes,
you
I
are.
Would, yeah.
Well, there's still a few diehards, you know, who are shocked when you come out proudly flaunting your national emblems.
That's
you know?
True.
Your maple leaf, your Mountie, your beaver.
Yeah.
And I'm a proud Australian. And I think more people would be happier and more fulfilled if they embraced their inner Canadian. I think they would.
I think being confident, being peaceful, being compassionate, being giving my best is my activism. My teacher said to me one time, there's only one thing that can't be taken from you, and that's your contentment. And I think that in application to being a gay person in our society is really an important thing to remember. If I've made any difference at all in society, not for the gay community only, but for the society in general, we're thinking about, we can't be so compartmentalized to think that it's only affecting the gay community. Really, when ignorance is dispelled, it helps everyone. So it's really about helping society in general and not just the gay community.
Canadian music icon Katie Lang may not have attended classes at the University of Regina, but she's now the owner of a shiny new doctorate degree from the school.
What an honor to be given a doctorate for being yourself.
Lang's honorary degree kicked off the degree presentations at the 40th Fall Convocation. The Juno and Grammy winner offered the class of almost 600 students some words of advice.
The essence of listening then shifts from listening to the outside world, which you still have to incorporate, to listening to your internal voice. And this goes beyond the students. This goes for us, the doctors.
My life is my voice, and my voice is my life. So it's very hard for me to say my voice does this and my life does this. Mm. It's all in one.
Through your voice, you've been able to tell that story, in a sense.
Through my voice, yes. Through my records, no.
Mm.
My records are so small, you know? They're just so small. They're 10 songs, and they're very, you know...
Do you see the records as a document of a process?
Oh, records are just a snapshot. Records are nothing. Records are nothing. They're postcards compared to a trip, you know?
Mm.
The records are just an ad. What I do for my voice is everything. Absolutely everything I do is for my voice. The fact that I'm a vegetarian, I don't eat dairy, I don't drink a lot, I certainly don't smoke. I exercise, I sleep, I drink a lot of water. The way I think is based on the protection of my gift, which is very, very spiritual, very, try to be very zen with it. You know, try to have extreme integrity with my art so that I don't sacrifice my gift. I take it very, very, very seriously. My warming up process starts as soon as I wake up. It's very important for me to have, you know, little things like open windows, no air conditioning, everything. I mean, it's like insane how much time and effort I put into it. To me, singing is the perfect balance between technical ease and freedom and emotional understanding of yourself and having those two woven perfectly and just completely not using this at all, not using your head, not analyzing, not even being aware, but just completely opening yourself up and letting it flow through you. I think that I haven't even begun to do the kind of music that I'm meant to do. I think that the pop realm is very limiting to me. But it's been a very good education, but it's not nowhere near where I want to be. Because I'm very, very fickle and I'm very promiscuous with my music. I really don't know. Honestly, I could say that I'm gonna do an opera and do, you know, heavy metal. I really I really have to follow my instincts, and I never know, even during the writing of a record, what's going to happen. I still believe I'm very relatively unknown. I think that, to me, I've done everything I can to make my career span my whole entire life, and that people, in fact, won't be aware of me until I'm gone. And that's a very romantic and very, in a way, selfish and self-righteous way to look at it, but that's honestly what I'm trying to do. To me, it's not about cashing in, you know, following a trend, cashing in, trying to get famous real quick. To me, it's about really developing as a singer. That's going to take a lifetime.
KD, this is your magical night.
Truth is pretty much everything. As an artist, I think as a human being in general, it's absolute.
And for 30 years, K.D. Lang has remained truthful to her calling and her gifts. Musically, she's been impossible to categorize.
K.D. can sing anything. Country, blues, pop, old torch songs. I mean, she's the real deal.
This idiosyncratic, wild, country, folk, pop, hybrid woman coming out of Alberta, she broke all the rules in a way.
Early in her career, she made an unforgettable impression with her first Juno win back in 1985.
I promise that I continue to sing for only the right reasons. Thank you very much. I love you.
KD headed to Nashville and her career blossomed. She captured her first Grammy Award with a duet with the legendary Roy Orbison.
To sing with him was extremely enlightening, not only musically, but personally and spiritually.
I want to sing you a love song.
Oh, there's a familiar face. She didn't stop there. In 1990, K.D. took home the Grammy for Best Country Female Vocalist.
The Grammy goes to K.D. Lang.
Wow, yeehaw.
Then, this ever-changing artist took a brave musical direction, recording the crossover album Ingenue, which yielded the biggest hit of K.D.'s career.
Oh, I'm scared of you. Constant craving. K.D. Lang.
She became a musical celebrity and branched out into all kinds of directions.
She was busting through and reaching people in ways that no industry could contain.
Colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky.
I would call her my greatest friend. She's just a beautiful human being and a great, great, great singer.
This collaboration garnered her yet another Grammy statue. But to really appreciate KD's talent, you have to see her live.
She sings without any obstacles between her and the listener. And because of that, she sings for all of us.
Her stage presence is incredible. She's fearless.
The audience adores her.
The first time I heard her sing Hallelujah, I found myself with a lump in my throat, and then I found myself crying. She stepped right in front of me, and I took her hand and kissed her hand because I was so moved and grateful by her rendition.
Today, I hope you feel a reflection back of what you've put out and bask in it.
No one deserves it more than you.
All the best to you.
KD, you have such a beautiful voice. This is so well earned. Well done.
Catherine Dawn Lang, please come and accept your award.
Hallelujah. 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 Your faith was strong, but you needed. Oh, baby, no. You,
Thank you so much. Of course, this one was a huge, had a huge impact on me. Phys ed teacher, bare feet. I had the biggest crush on her. I still do. To my family and my friends, my collaborators, Warner Brothers, my managers, my bandmates, and my fans over the years, this too is your moment. And I want to offer you my most profound gratitude. Thank you so, so, so much for all your support over the years. I think the fact that I'm standing here receiving this award actually says more about Canada than it does about me. Because only in Canada could there be such a freak as Katie Lang receiving this award. Only in Canada could there be people like Stompin' Tom Connors and Rita McNeil. So I am here to tell you, my friends and my countrymen, that it is okay to be you. It is okay to let your freak flags fly and embrace the quirkmeister that's inside of all of us. And I'm not even just talking artists. I'm talking every single person in this nation has the right to be themselves, live life, go team go. I love you, Canada. Thank you so much.
What are your hopes and dreams? Sing forever. Sing until I'm 98.
I just wanna be here with you, not bracing for what comes next. I got some new words, I can see sideways. If there's a limit, it hasn't found me yet. Don't you ever stop. The hungry fools who rule the world can't catch us. Surely they can't ruin everything. I just wanna be here with you, not bracing for what comes next.